right? After finding, just now we have found out determinant, and now we need to write this particular thing in our answer sheet, in our examination sheet. System of equations will be consistent or inconsistent according as adjoint of B equal to 0 or adjoint of A into B is not equal to 0. That means if it is equal to 0, it is consistent and possesses infinitely many solutions, and if it is not equal to 0, it will be inconsistent. Now what I'll be doing means, now adjoint A I found out, adjoint of A means it is a matrix obtained by finding the transpose of the cofactor matrix. Now what I'll be doing means, therefore I'll be finding out adjoint A into B. What is our adjoint A here? 0 0 0 minus 3 3 and here minus 3 3 into its B. B means what here? 3 2 1. So we shall multiply this. Is matrix multiplication possible? Yes, it is possible, because number of columns in the first matrix is equal to number of rows in the second matrix. I think first row will always be 0, because 0 into 3 plus 0 into 2 plus 0 into 1. This becomes minus 3 into 3, 9. 9 plus minus 9 plus 6 is minus 3. And minus 3 plus 3 will become all 0. This all side becomes 0. So similarly, last element will also be equal to 0. So we obtain adjoint of A into B is equal to 0. So therefore what can I tell? Therefore finally we can conclude like this. I think now det A we obtained as 0 and adjoint of A into B also we obtained as 0. That implies system is consistent with infinitely many solutions. Therefore, we need to solve the given system. X minus y plus z equal to 3. 2x plus y minus z equal to 2, and x minus minus x minus 2y plus 2z equal to 1. I call this as 1, this as 2, and this as 3. This as 3. So now what I'll be doing means, I will add 1 plus 2. I think yy is getting cancelled and zz is also getting cancelled. And now 1 plus 2. So what happens? Yy and zz cancel. So 3x is equal to 5 I obtain. So x is equal to 5 by 3. Now what I'll be doing means, put x is equal to 5 by 3 in 3. So x means minus 5 by 3 minus 2y. 2z equal to 1. So minus 2y plus 2z is equal to 1 plus 5 by 3, that is equal to 8 by 3. So what happens? Minus 2y plus 2z is equal to 8 by 3. Now what I'll be doing means, this time let y equal to k I will be keeping. If I keep y is equal to k, what happens? Minus 2k plus 2z equal to 8 by 3. So what happens? That implies 2z is equal to 8 by 3 plus 2k. That implies 2z is equal to 8 plus 6k by 3. That implies z is equal to 8 plus 6k by 6. That means z I can write as 4 by 3, because 2 3s are 2 4s are 8 by 3 plus k. Therefore, we got what? X is 5 by 3. I assumed y as k, and I got z is equal to 4 by 3 plus k, where k belongs to, this is where k belongs to capital R. We shall see once again x is 5 by 3. We need to put x is equal to 5 by 3 in 3. That means third equation minus 5 by 3 minus 2y plus 2z equal to 1. So minus 2y plus 2z is equal to 5 by 3 going to that side, 1 plus 5 by 3. 1 plus 5 by 3 is 8 by 3. So minus 2y plus 2z is equal to 8 by 3. I kept y is equal to k. So what happens? Minus 2k plus 2z is equal to 8 by 3. 2z is equal to 8 by 3 plus 2k. So LCM 2z is equal to 8 plus 6k by 3. So what happens? Z is equal to 8 plus 6k by 6. So 8 by 6 means 4 by 3 because 2 4s are 2 3s and here k. So we got x is equal to 5 by 3, y equal to k, z is equal to 4 by 3 plus k. Hence, we should write k belongs to R. This is the pattern where the system is consistent and is possessing infinite number of solutions. Now, we shall be knowing about the properties of determinants. Before starting these properties of determinants, I would like to explain the physical shape of the determinant. Determinant means here I will be considering only 3 by 3 determinant. If suppose determinant is of like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This one we call as first row. First row is denoted by R1. This one we call as second row. It is denoted by R2. And this one we call as the third row. It is denoted by R3. And this particular one we call as column. As it is a first column, we denote it as C1, and this as C2, and as this is the third column, I denote it as C3. Sometimes I want to interchange rows. That means in place of R1 I need to have R2, and in place of R2 I need to have R1. That means I use the symbol R1 double implies R2. In general, we shall be using Ri interchanged with Rj. That means this we can call as interchange of Ri with Rj and Rj with Ri. That means interchange, right? For interchanging, we will be using this symbol. If suppose like that, we can interchange columns also. So columns are being columns interchange is denoted by C1 double implies C2. In general, Ci double implies Cj, right? So these are the two symbols you should remember. And sometimes I'll be using another one. R1 implies R1 plus R2 or R1 minus R2. That means when I add R1 plus R2, I need to get R1. That means while doing or while performing the row operations in the determinants, I may add R1 plus R2 to get an R1. That means for finding out R1, sometimes I will be adding R1 plus R2 of the previous determinant to get a new determinant, right? Similarly, subtraction can also be done. And sometimes C1 implies C1 plus C2 or C1 implies C1 minus C2 for columns also. And sometimes I may use like this, R1 implies R1 plus 2R2 or R1 minus 2R2. That means for R2 I multiplied by 2 and that net result I added to the previous R1 for getting a new R1 in the new determinant. These are the notations you should remember before dealing with the properties, right? Now we are learning to properties of determinants. Now we are learning the properties of determinants. What the first property is telling means If suppose determinant is denoted by delta, if suppose determinant is denoted by delta, then what he is telling means delta is equal to delta dash. Or if A is any matrix, then determinant of A is equal to determinant of its transpose. That means, or in our language, what can I tell? If any row is changed to column and vice versa, the value of determinant does not change. That means det A is equal to det A whole transpose, or if it is denoted by delta, I can tell delta is equal to delta dash. I go by an example to show that A is equal to det A transpose. Example, let capital A is equal to, capital A is equal to, I take as 1 2 3 2 3 4 0 1 5. I try to find its determinant. If I find its determinant, what happens? 1 into its minor, 1 3 3 4 and 1 5, plus again here what happens? Minus 2 into its minor, minus 2 into its minor means 2 4 0 5, and 3 into its minor, that means 2 3 0 1. If you could observe carefully, 1 into 15 minus 4 minus 2 into 10 minus 0 plus 3 into 2 minus 0. So 15 minus 4 is 11, 11 minus 20 plus 6, 11 plus 6 17, 17 minus 20 is minus 3. So we obtained that A is equal to minus 3. Now what I'll be doing means, this time I'll be finding out A transpose, and here I'm doing but A transpose. But A transpose means what we'll be getting here, like this, row should be changed to column, 2, 3, 1 and 3, 4, 5. Now here also I'll be finding out determinant of A transpose. Determinant of A transpose means that matrix, there will be finding a determinant using the first row, that means 3, 1, 4, 5, and later minus 2 into, we need to denote this corresponding column and corresponding row. So what will be having? 2, 1, 3, 5 plus 0 and anything will be 0. So here 15 minus 4 minus of 2 into 10 minus 3. So 11 and 10 minus 3 is 7, 7 into 2 is 14, 11 minus 14 is minus 3. If you could observe carefully, determinant of A transpose is minus 3 and the determinant of A is minus 3. Therefore, I can tell that A is equal to det A transpose. Right? So property 1 is clear. When rows are changed into columns and columns are changed into rows, the determinant doesn't change. This is the very first important property you should remember. We are going to see the second property. What second property is telling means, if any two rows or columns are interchanged, then the sign of determinant changes, but value remains same. But value remains same. That is, symbolically I can tell delta is equal to minus delta dash. Delta dash is the new determinant obtained when two rows or columns are interchanged. Example, I'll be taking a matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, 1, 2, right? If you think this as capital A, I want to interchange, this is R1 I call, this is R2 and this is R3. I want to interchange R2 and R3. When I interchange R2 and R3, I will be obtaining a new determinant or a new matrix. How I will be obtaining means 1, 2, 3, because I am going to change R2 and R3. Interchange R2 and R3 means we should use this symbol. And what happens? 0, 1, 2 and here 4, 5, 6. So if you could observe carefully, 0, 1, 2 is going up and 4, 5, 6 is coming up. Rows had been interchanged, two particular rows has been interchanged. So what happens here? We need to keep minus sign. So finally, we shall calculate and we shall verify. I'll be finding out determinant of A here. So 1 into its minor, 1 into its minor means every time I won't write, directly I'll be calculating. 5 into 2 is 10, 10 minus 6 is 4. Next, minus 2 into its minor. Minus 2 into its minor means we need to delete the corresponding column and corresponding row. That means we need to find minor of 4602. That means 4 2 is 8. Plus 3 into its minor. 3 into its minor means we need to delete the corresponding column and corresponding row. So we will be getting 4, because 0 into 5 will be 0. So 4 minus 16 plus 12. I think we are getting 0 if you could observe carefully. 4 minus 16 plus 12, that will be 0. Right? Now we shall be checking for this, whether we will be getting the same thing or not. So determinant of A dash, and here I will be taking minus symbol to this side. Okay? Now we shall see. So here I will be writing another step, because minus a dash I will be taking here. So there remains 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. We shall check. So what happens? 1 into its minor. That means 6 minus 10. 6 minus 10 is minus 4. And here minus 2 into its minor. Minus 2 into its minor means 0 into 6 minus 2 into 4, that means minus 8. 0 into 6 minus 2 into 4, so that will be minus 8. And later plus 3 into its minor, 0 into 5, and here minus 4, right? So what happens here also? Minus 4 plus 16 minus 12, it is also becoming equal to 0. Therefore, what happens? Determinant of A is equal to minus determinant of A dash. So what we can conclude? If any two rows or columns are interchanged, the sign of the determinant changes, but the value remains same. That is the meaning of delta is equal to minus delta dash.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.